Hello everybody, welcome back to Simulated Heaven and welcome back to Train Sim 2014. I have a very interesting thing for you now. This is a new add-on by the people at Just Trains. It's, as you can see, a CRH1 high-speed train from China. I believe we're going from Suining to Chengdu. And as you can see, this is the tutorial, so it's explaining some things. So it's saying first we need to raise the pantograph, find the control button on the left upside of the control panel to raise it. And then it's explaining about the HUD here, the safety system switch. You can adjust your train speed before or after you enter the next speed. Okay, so the safety speed thing is on by default. Anyway, I did already have a look at this, so I do have some idea how it works. This is like the introductory thing for this this train. So let's look at the outside of the train first. So like I said, it's a high-speed train from China. Does look quite nice. There goes another one. Now, regarding the modelling of this train, it does look quite nice, but it just feels that some things are slightly low res. I'm not sure if that is a problem with the game itself, with Train Sim, but I don't know. I mean, it looks pretty nice, but there is something about it that just feels a little bit flat at times. You see, like when I zoom in there on the door, I don't know, it might just be because it's a white train that maybe. I mean, it's pretty good for a train sim, but maybe it is just because I've been playing a lot of flight sims recently and I kind of am used to the very high res things you get on there. I believe I paid about 33 US for the train and also including the route, the high speed route. Let's look inside the cab. So it's quite interesting. As you can see, we have a HUD here, which is kind of cool. So this is like a speed limit, which is apart from the speed limit in the game. Yeah, it's explaining some things, but I think I can explain it relatively okay. So as you can see, it says that the speed limit right now is 90, and these yellow signals are kind of helping to indicate that. And then I believe the second bit here is like an upcoming speed limit, and it is telling you how far the distance until that speed limit. And sometimes the limit on here is slightly different from the other limit in the game. And if it has a green light here, that means that you can basically go up to the speed of, I believe, 250 if it just has a green light here. So that's kind of cool. Now, there are some interesting buttons here. There's an emergency button that you can click. There's a key for startup. Okay, yep. So basically, as it is explaining here, we're heading to Chengdu East Railway Station. After that, when we've unloaded, we then have to go, we have to then return back here to the depot. Yeah, so then over here we have got a horn, which sounds pretty good. Then I believe the next thing we have over here, this is the cruise control. So we have the wipers here, the green button is the wipers. Then we have, so this is the basic cruise control. If you turn it on, it will maintain the current speed of your train, which is kind of cool. But the thing that's even more cool, or even cooler I should say, is the advanced cruise control. If you have this on, it will basically make sure that the train at all times is at the current speed limit, which is awesome, which is really good for when I'm outside of the cab like this and I kind of want to see the scenery. So that is kind of cool. The one thing I would kind of slightly complain about, I haven't really noticed anything that comes up on the HUD or any of the systems here that will actually tell you whether the cruise control is on or not. So you kind of have to remember that when the button is up, it's off, and when it is down, it's on. I think it's like that. I don't know. It's slightly confusing. Like I said, I kind of wish there was an obvious thing here that was telling me if it was on or not. I don't know if I missed that. Maybe I did. So yeah, and then obviously we have the lever here, which is basically the same as the red lever here on my HUD on the controls of the game, the regular controls of the game. This here is a reverser. I'm not quite sure what that is for. That's one thing I've not really learned about. Now, kind of looking around, it looks like quite a dark interior. And again, some of the things here look kind of low res. I'm kind of used to very high res things in flight sims. I think for this game it's pretty good, but I think it maybe could be slightly better. I mean, these kind of things here, I don't know, maybe I'm asking for too much, but I just feel it could maybe be slightly more high res. But when I am talking about these kind of things, I'm not really sure if it's a restriction from the actual game. It makes me wonder if the train sim engine is not really, really good enough, like, to make everything look as high res as, say, Euro Truck Simulator 2, or like, say, some of the flight sims. It kind of makes me wonder, because again, if you have a look at the railway station here, it looks quite nice, but some of the things look quite flat or quite low res. So yeah, that might just be an issue with the game itself. I don't know, but I suppose if I am paying $30 for this, I kind of expect slightly higher res, but maybe that is just me. Okay, so we basically have to head off to, like I said, to Chengdu East Station, which is just under 18 kilometers away. And I think we're going to be a bit late because I've been talking so much. Now, I have to raise the pantograph thing, which is basically the thing that goes up onto the electric wires here. It did kind of explain that I can press a button here, but when I'm hovering over them, it doesn't seem to be giving me anything. So usually what I will do is I will use the HUD, like the general kind of control HUD I have here from the game. And I know that this one here is the button for that, the pantograph. So I'm going to click that. It should go up. Or not, as the case may be. No, so I'm wondering if I have to click the start key. Okay. I'm not sure about that. That's weird. I did do this one time before, it didn't have this problem. The pantograph, for some reason, refuses to go up. That is kind of weird. Okay, let's see. I mean, these buttons... Oh! What did that do? I just clicked a button and a noise. I heard a noise. I don't know. Interesting. See, I didn't realize I had to actually play around with these things here. And I find the key a little bit annoying to turn. As you can see. Seems like it's only got two positions. That is weird. Oh, no, hang on. Why is the pantograph still not going up? We're moving. Did it go up without me realizing? Oh, guys, that is a bug. Look at that. No wonder I had an issue there. Okay, let's slow the train down a bit because we don't want it straight away. Interesting. So as you can see, as it looks to me anyway, it looks like the pantograph. Oh, it is up now. That's weird. I don't know what happened there. Okay, well, apologies about that. Oh, but the one at the front is still not up. Look. That's weird. I thought that's a pantograph right there, the red thing. But it hasn't gone up. Only the one at the back. Is that kind of how it's supposed to work? Okay, anyway. So that's obviously why I thought there was a problem when there maybe wasn't a problem. Anyway, we need to crack on. We're going to be kind of late here. But hey, it's okay. We're already like way behind schedule. So let's just try to get out of the 90 speed limit area onto the more unrestricted area. I'm not going to use the cruise control yet. So actually, maybe I didn't have to click the key because it's in the original position that it was in. Or maybe it was that I clicked the button here. Maybe the button I clicked here was the one that actually made the pantograph go up. And I need to keep to 90. If you can see, the speed limit here is 90, but the speed limit in the game is 250. But now it is basically gone to the full 250. We have a green light here. So yeah, maybe what happened there is maybe I clicked a button here, which was for the pantograph, and maybe I did only raise... Oh, this is the pantograph. Oh, there you go. So no, so I didn't do anything. I don't think I clicked any of these ones. So that's the pantograph thing that you need here, right? And I'm gonna... So I don't know what I did there. Anyway. It's all a learning experience. I'm gonna put the cruise control on. And I'm gonna put the advanced cruise control on. Oh, hang on, is that working? Excuse me. Need a bit of a sneeze there. Now, I have to say, the frame rate in this when you go fast is not very good. The frame rate when you're going at a regular speed is quite good. But as you can probably see from the video, I mean, obviously it's not helped by recording, but I'm only really getting about 3 or 4 FPS less than I was actually getting when I was not recording. And it does have a tendency to get slightly low, or you know, fairly low FPS when I am at high speed, which is kind of a shame. But again, I don't know if that's a limit of this particular mod or of the game, but it would be nicer if it was slightly smoother. Anyway, so here we go. We are cruising our way towards Chengdu East Station. We're going quite fast now. We're getting close to the top speed. And yeah, I believe I have got the dynamic cruise control on because it is slowing itself to keep under the 230 speed limit. You see here, it's got a speed limit in the game of 250, but the train itself has got a limit of 230. So that dynamic cruise control is really cool. Now, the feeling of speed in this train is kind of nice. And as you can see, the speed is automatically altering itself down to 200. So that dynamic cruise control is a really, really cool thing if you are driving from outside of the cab and you just want to relax and enjoy the view. So yeah, the feeling of speed is really, really good in this train. It's not really helped at the moment because I'm recording and it's slightly low FPS. I was still getting quite low FPS when I was not recording. But it wasn't as bad as it is right now. So the feeling of speed is pretty alright, but it's not really helped while recording because the slightly lower FPS. Anyway, let's show you this view and the horn. Yay. Now, I've already kind of talked about the train. I think it looks like a nice one in terms of this game. You know, not amazing, but pretty decent, a pretty decent effort. Now, the scenery, I would say the exact same thing about the scenery that I said about the other things with the modeling. I feel like it's good. It looks pretty nice. It looks pretty realistic. It looks like they have tried to model everything exactly how it is in real life. But everything just looks a little bit flat, slightly flat. And especially, you know, when I'm in the cab, the actual the fencing and the things around the track just look slightly flat to me. And I just feel like the game would be helped so much more if they could make everything kind of come alive a bit. But like I said, I mean, I think Euro Truck Simulator 2 has really raised the bar for this kind of scenery, and I have a feeling it might just be more a limit of the game itself. So when the next version of Train Simulator is out, I believe they need to do something with the engine, like to make it so that, you know, it looks a bit more you know, higher res, and that the FPS is a bit more consistent. Like right now, even though we're in like a city area, like a built-up area, I'm actually getting really good FPS now. Like, well, I've got about 30 FPS, which is actually pretty all right at the moment with recording. And you can see that does help with the feeling of the scenery. When you have a good FPS, you do really feel that the scenery is slightly better. So yeah. But yeah, so I'm pretty happy with the scenery and with all of the modeling. It looks pretty nice, but just maybe I'm just used to a slightly higher res thing. Some of the buildings look slightly flat and things like that, but hey, maybe I'm just asking way too much. So this is kind of cool. As you can see, we're still being dynamically controlled by the cruise control. I mean, if you are actually driving from inside the cab, of course it would be kind of boring if you were always using this, but it is really handy if you are outside of the cab. So we are heading up to the platform. We are only just under a couple of kilometers away, so we're cruising up nice and slow. I'm going to show you guys the wipers. There you go. It's nice having some wipers, even though we don't need them right now. Yes, I don't know why at the start, like, I think, like I said, when you're high speed, it makes the FPS quite a lot lower, you know, because it's obviously having to process the scenery a lot faster. So going at this kind of speed, I'm getting a nice 30 FPS, and it's really helping me feel a lot better about the level of the scenery, you know. I mean, actually, I have never been to Chengdu, but I have lived in China, and it does kind of look like what I would expect a Chinese city to look like. So I definitely think they have tried hard, like, to get everything in the right place. But like I said, I just have this feeling that maybe, you know, it's just slightly flat looking. Okay, so we are literally heading up to the platform, as you could see. I feel like we're maybe going a little bit fast, but that's okay. Let's cruise up. Yeah, it does look pretty cool, doesn't it? Pretty cool. And it is interesting driving a high-speed train from China. It's not often you get to do that. Okay, so I believe we need to stop at the end of the platform. I'm not sure. It doesn't seem to have a marker that I can see, so I'm just going to stop at the end. And I would say the same thing about this railway station. It looks pretty nice. It's got a lot of detail, but everything just looks slightly flat again. I think we're going too fast here, guys. Okay, maybe I need to take off the cruise control, maybe. I am going to go right to the end. I don't see a marker that says please stop here or anything like that. Maybe I missed it. But I just stop at the end of the platform to hopefully help with that. Okay. Cool. Now he stopped right there, and yeah, whatever. Let's ignore him. So let's open. Like so, we are slightly late. Like I said, I did expect that. Now I do rather like the detailing on the interior, but when I click on this view, I mean the interior of the train looks pretty nice, but there's just something with the modeling that I just feel could be improved. The biggest thing is this big white thing here, which is on the back of the seats. It just looks kind of garish. I wonder if they can actually do that any better, but it's kind of nice to have. What? You failed to stop at Chengdu East Railway Station. No, I actually stopped. I'm here right now, aren't I? The sign says Chengdu East. Yes, it does. I stopped here, but for some reason it won't accept that. I have no idea why. How bizarre. So maybe there was like a point I should have stopped at, which I didn't stop at. Is there a log? Stop at Chengdu East 06. So what am I at now? I want to get rid of that. 06. Yeah, this is platform 6. So how strange. So I do kind of find this is a bit of an issue with some of the add-ons for this game, that it can be slightly glitchy. There are some things that don't, you know, that will say that you have failed when you can't work out why. I mean, if anyone who is watching this can actually see why I failed, but I, you know, I can't really tell. I stopped in the green area of the platform. I couldn't see anywhere else that, you know, that I'd have to stop, if you know what I mean. I mean, I don't know. We are at platform 6. I mean, this is now the rear of the train. Whoa, what are these dudes doing? All standing in a line. Hello, we're having a lovely trip in China. We're all just standing here train spotting. We love to train spot in China. Don't you? Whoa. Yeah, I don't know what happened there. Anyway, so thanks for watching the video. I'm not going to do the return journey on video because I think you guys have seen it enough. I will try and do other videos with this train. It does have a number of scenarios, so hopefully I will see you guys in the next video. Of course, I'll put a link in the description to this add-on. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.